The captain has turned on the seatbelt sign. Please return to your seat and fasten your seatbelt.
I always fly first, and I only buy coach. That's right, big seats, fancy food, lay flat beds, priority everything, and ice cream sundaes. All for the price of that shitty middle seat in the back of the plane. This movie explains how.
Hello, my name is Dr. Green Thumb. I'd like to tell you just where I'm from. In the hills where the trees go wild with wheat fields. No fucking pigs with shields holding the blue steel. Greenhouse effect with the wheat connect.
Okay, so there's no trick or anything secretive about this process, but since someone had to explain it to me, I thought I'd pay it forward and explain it to the internet. First, to access these privileges, you have to fly a lot. If you don't fly a lot, the truth is you'll always be stuck in the back. I'm sorry. Okay, you fly a lot. All this is a complete exploitation of an airline's loyalty program. It's like dating. Sure, it's fun to mess around with every bird in the sky, but if you want her to love you back, she needs you to commit. In this case, she's the airline. Now, I've committed to American Airlines, partially because they have the best loyalty program, mainly because they have the best name, American. Okay, so commitment equals loyalty, and loyalty gets you status. Status is the end game. It's your golden ticket. As an Advantage Elite status member, you'll enjoy a world of perks and benefits. American has three status levels: gold, platinum, and executive platinum. Status is earned by one metric and one metric only, the elite qualifying mile. An elite qualifying mile is not a frequent flyer mile. You can't earn them with credit cards or anything like that. They're earned only by time in the air. Hence rule number one.
Hi, first class, business class?
Yep. I make the LA to New York flight the most, so I'll use that as a control. One round-trip flight from New York to LA earns you about 5,000 elite qualifying miles, which sounds like a lot, but to get gold, which isn't much help with the upgrades, you need 25,000 of those elite qualifying miles. Platinum, which is sometimes helpful, you need 50,000. But to catch the goose that lays the golden eggs, Executive Platinum, with its unlimited complimentary upgrades, for that you need 100,000 elite qualifying miles. It's a lot to ask, but since sitting up front is what it's all about, this is where you need to be. The last step in this process is the most punishing. You have to earn those 100,000 elite qualifying miles inside of 12 months. And your reward for that is a one-year membership to the coolest club in the skies. But on the first of the year, every year, your precious elite qualifying mile balance gets reset to zero. To maintain the status you need to stay in the club, you have to keep earning those 100,000 elite qualifying miles every year. That's it. That's the process. It's complicated and there are no loopholes, but they're giving you the keys to the kingdom. Why would they make it easy? All the perks do make the experience a lot better. So, if you fly a lot, this is the best way to do it. Unless, of course, you have one of these things.